I'd like to reiterate a lot of what the chairwoman said. As I said before in our committee, a lot of meetings and a lot of hard work, and the chairwoman is a class act, and the vice chair and all the members on the majority party. Like we said, we all like each other, but I think sometimes there's just big philosophical differences. And special thanks to my committee on the budget committee and getting through, quite a few days and a lot of hearings. And OLS did an amazing job, and on the Republican staff here in Trenton did an amazing job. And I don't want to beat a dead horse, but I wish, the one, I know this is our third budget in 2 years because of the pandemic, but, I guess when you see the most liberal groups in the state and in the newspapers agreeing with Republicans, we're probably, I know we're right, that the only fault I had was there could have been a lot more transparency and a lot more time. And, I know everyone said it happened in the past, but the Democratic legislators control the agenda, and we could have taken whatever time we needed. And there's literally votes being made on bills that hadn't even been posted yet, votes being made on and left before they were even posted. And hey, it is what it is. And I just wish we had more time to go through it. And the chairwoman did offer us time, but it wasn't enough time to go through the amount of documents that we were and presented with. And it may always been done that way. And my advice going forward is to try not to do it that way in the future, because the public had reached out, and other people reached out, and so we can't even comment on the language because we don't have a clue what the language is. And I think it was a total of 12 minutes on a $46 billion budget, and maybe the Senate was 10 minutes on the budget. And so that would be, my number one ask or request. I think we all want as many people as possible to see and to be able to go through and see how their hard-earned money is spent. Now, the issue with the budget, the $45 billion was mind-boggling and staggering to most people. To go up to $46.5 billion, not counting the supplemental spending, that's a 15% increase from last year. Since the governor's been in office, we're up to 35% increase. That's insanity spending. That just can't be sustained. I think most people, 15% is mind-boggling. And the natural tax revenue was off by $5 billion. So, what puts us in the rating and the $215 billion of debt the state has and is the continuous spending. This was our opportunity. And one of the colleagues on the budget committee said, we should be celebrating this, and we should be celebrating. There's a lot of good things in here. There's no question. The pension payment, the EIT, the homestead, Mr. Speaker, there's a lot of good things. But we got to remember, you're celebrating with other people's money. And I've said that the big party is the taxpayers who is paying for. So obviously, the 60 new taxes in the last 3 years, the 7 new taxes during the height of the pandemic on the folks in New Jersey, we were, I think, the only state in the nation to raise taxes during the pandemic. We were one of two states in the nation that borrowed money that my side of the aisle kept saying we don't need. This is an unnecessary amount of borrowing. Originally, the governor thought $30 billion, $20 billion, $10 billion, went to the Supreme Court, $9 billion, ended up with $4 billion, and then a headline flashes $10 billion surplus. And I would even think kids in the first, second grade math would say, how in God's name can you have a surplus when you owe $215 billion? It just defies common sense or common accounting. So while there's good things to be done in here, it means that we overtax the residents of New Jersey, which I've been saying since I've been here, and many of us have been saying, and that's their money. And while I appreciate that we gave some back, as I said in the earlier comments, it's a minuscule amount. The new tax givebacks are $93 million. That wasn't announced, the difference between what was announced in Governor Murphy's first budget. So I think a lot more of that money should have been returned to the taxpayers, and we should have put even more aside for the rainy day fund. The surplus is really an unsecured amount of about $500 million when you draw down the actual numbers. And the reason I think more should have been returned to the taxpayers, $3.7 billion of the surplus was from income tax. So to return $93 million after you took in $3.7 billion just doesn't seem right. And I think we missed an opportunity on education to do more funding on education. Obviously, the UI is a disaster. There should have been money put into UI. The folks are going to face a huge tax coming up very shortly. The IT equipment in many agencies, including UI, as our offices know, and DMV and et cetera, there was nothing, you know, minuscule amount, $17 million, the lowest estimates are $100 million to do anything that would make a difference other than Band-Aids. So those are my and my committee's main points that we differ on the budget tremendously. And, you know, transit, there wasn't a penny for transit. And I think a lot more could have been done, but this amount of spending and spending $5 billion more than you took in is just wrong. This was our chance, I think, to get our house in order, and the pension was good, but we could have done a lot more to benefit the citizens and the residents of New Jersey, maybe apologize for borrowing money we didn't need, and maybe apologize for taking too much of their hard-earned money that we didn't need. So I urge everybody to vote no on this, and let's try to get it a little better. $46.5 billion is crazy. Thank you.